bounce. I like my girl to throw. Bounce. I like my girl to throw. Bounce. I like my girl to throw.
Check, check, check.
Bounce.
Check, check, check.
I like my girl to throw gang signs.
We going in. 20 and 20 with my brother Lendale White. 20 and 20, I got Showcase White coming in.
I'm Silla, self-sinner, sinner. Go figure, figure.
Y'all run it up, share the live, share the live. Tag somebody, tell somebody we on.
Pick winner, simply. Been doing that, few losses here and there, but it's how you react.
Tell somebody we on right now. Showcase White coming in right now.
Swiftly, like a swifter, dusty niggas don't have a shot. Smooth as MJ, Deion Sanders, I'm still brave. This hardened with the step back, I just shave. I talk about.
I said I got the legend.
I like my girl to throw gangs.
The running back legend, USC legend, Denver legend, Tennessee Titan legend. Lendale White coming in. Female Shooter, what up? PH Customs, what up? Beast Mode, what up? I need y'all in here. It's going to be a good one today. Beast Mode, tag somebody. Let's go.
I'm still a self-centered sinner. Go figure, figure. Most dwindle Denver. Ain't friendly women. Pick winner simply. Been doing that. Few losses here and there, but it's how you react. I react quickly, quickest. Cool with me, swiftly. Like a swifter, dusty niggas don't have.
Big shout out to Iman, Iman Sacks. What up? What up, Sacks?
Sanders, I'm still brave. This hardened with the step back. I just shave. I talk about money, honey, and showing homies self-preservation.
We going in. Lendale coming in here in a quick second.
Heaven glacier. Call like a spaceship. I'm alienated. Makes sense. That down to earth. Women walk around him. We chilling like a motherfucker. A little bit. She gon' wanna fuck.
Big shout to PH Customs for my shirt, my Sade shirt. Y'all see my shirt?
Wear a rubber with it.
You gotta see my socks, so I'm gonna show y'all my socks too. Holla at PH Customs if you need something custom.
Fuck about my face. Get gone. Get the fuck up out my face. Get gone. I'm still a self-sinner, sinner. Big pimpin', really. Spin binges, frankly. Thank, stanky, thank me. Then thank me again. You've been needing this. Relax and let my tongue play on your clitoris. You've been wanting me. You in front of me. Quit fronting, bitch.
Denver, Colorado, rebelling, what's happening?
Number man, Iman the number man. They count it up, then double man. They don't tell no one nothing, cause they run their mouth.
Make sure y'all follow Showcase White, shit. Showcase White.
Info and Pippins, Pimpins, pass it this.
Follow Iman S.
Swing, swing behind the back.
Follow PH underscore customs, PH underscore customs, they gonna get you right.
Swing, swing behind the back, Iman, fuck about my face. Get gone, get the fuck up out my face. Get gone, get the fuck up out my face. Get gone, get the fuck up out my face. Get gone. Get the fuck up out my face. Get gone. Get the fuck up out my face. Get gone. Get the fuck up out my face. Get gone. Get the fuck up out my face. Get gone.
I got the legend Showcase White coming in a minute. Lendale White.
Certified niggas ass body.
In the meantime, run me up.
His
run me up. Tag somebody for the live. Tag somebody. Why? Tell them they need to be on right now.
That I think I done went up a size. She tell me she agree, that's when I cut the ties.
Big shout to AP. AP, what's happening? Sex, what's happening?
Cause kings need crowns, can't swim, bitch, drown. 100 rounds on me while I'm running through the town. I ain't scared of nothing, bitch, we'll gun your nigga down. Line up all the ones you want, I bet we knock them out of bounds. Fuck a whistle, wear your pistol, niggas jerseys turn to gowns. You should be embarrassed when they win the short frown. But your daddy,
let's go, Showcase, let's go, Showcase.
Then he had the nerve to be who talking at the trial. Lips ran 100 miles, speak of all in apples. Yeah,
hey.
she said
hello. If your daddy was a bitch, oh jeez, hello.
Say they had me get rich. I heard every single word I've been having ever since. Now it's looking like a winning streak.
Hey, Showcase White in the building. I got my little brother Lendale White in the building. Hold up. Let me let the vibe out real quick. Let me let the vibe out, Lendale, real quick, real quick. Big shout to AP. Big shout to Sex. What's that? Iman S. What up?
You can't sell demons without Iman.
Y'all get ready. We gonna holla at Lendale. We gonna holla at Lendale.
I don't know how they comparing me, so I popped up the clip.
shit a narrative. I'm arrogant by definition, but apparently. Wait, humble pine on y'all play evil. Greedy Mac, and always got room to dessert sweeties.
Hey.
Only throwing up my squeeze. Try and take what's on my neck. Call the preacher, he should feature on this.
Y'all run the numbers up, real quick. Share that live real quick,
Touch niggas, easy. Eat pills in your butt, bitches. Khalifa. Everybody know I feel best, and I ain't even talk about my clothes yet. I'm fresher than the rest of y'all. My ego make me.
We going in. Wait, tell somebody it's a Denver thing, it's a Park Hill thing. We going in right now. Hold up.
ShowCase White in the building.
Yes, Sirski. What up, big bro? What it do?
What's up with my bro, man?
You know I'm cooling. I can't complain, man. Staying out the way, that's about it.
Yeah, that's the best way.
Yeah, what's good with you?
The best way. What's up? I'm good, man. You know, first of all, I want to say thank you, man. Appreciate you for even hopping on with me right now. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. You know, man, listen, we go this too far back not to do this. This whatever you need, I told you that.
On everything. So, you know, this.
Yes, sir.
This the 2020. I got to tell everybody. I'll let you know. This the 2020 with DJ Ktone. Look, 20 questions. In 20
yes,
minutes.
Yes, sir.
But you know, we family, so give or take a couple. It's probably going to be a couple more than 20 questions. And we got some questions for people, too. So I'm going to try to answer, get some of the people's questions in, who sent some questions in. For those that don't know, man, ShowCase White, man, how did you get that name? How did you acquire that name, ShowCase?
ShowCase came from Allen Webb and Quentin Tweed.
Okay.
We was all, you know, we all went to high school. We've been hanging out our whole lives, so.
Yeah.
We always coming up with, like, nicknames and stuff. And, you know, back then I used to talk a lot of stuff, you know. And you know, they was like, ShowCase fits you. So, you know, because I displayed a lot of stuff at that time. So
right.
It just stuck with me, man. You know, ever since then, it's been a part of the, you know, what I go by.
So, growing up in Denver, you know, Park Hill to be exact, man, was it hard for people like, you know, in other states in football to really take you serious, like, Not serious because
yeah. Dude, no, I know what you're saying. Yeah, I already know what you're saying.
Because they don't really take it serious in Denver, man. In
yeah, sports. Colorado football ain't exactly. High on the map.
Exactly.
Yeah, so when I was going to certain camps back then, you know, I'd go to like Nebraska camps, you know, Texas, whatnot.
Right.
I even played an All-American game and stuff. So when you would go there, niggas would always be like, you know, like, man, is there black people there? Like, you know, I always get that joke and they'd be like, oh, y'all play football. So there was always an edge on my shoulder, you know what I mean? Just because you always hear about this California, you hear about this Texas, you know, you hear about Florida football.
Yeah.
But you don't never hear about Colorado. So, you know, like I always had an edge when it came to that. And when I got out to California, you know, always hearing about Cali boys, I was like, listen, I got to leave my name out here. They're going to feel me when I leave.
Yeah, on everything. How'd you dodge the street politics, man, and the gangs? From where you came from, and how did you like manage to dodge that growing up?
Well, you know, shout out to my mom Anita and my uncle Herman White.
Yeah.
You know, they definitely was a cornerstone growing up. Obviously, when you grow up in Park Hill, you know, even my big cousin Chauncey,
he was
so influential without him knowing. You know, because I seen him go, so I always knew in the back of my mind you can do something. You know, you can go to the league, and you know that was one of my dreams. So seeing that. You know, my Uncle Herman would, you know, always tell me about certain things. And you would see, you know, like I had older cousins, Herman, you know, Darcy Levy.
Right.
Some of these guys, you would see people that they played with. And, you know, they had just as much talent as anybody. They wouldn't make it. And, you know, some of the fools just gangbanging.
Right.
You know, they couldn't control it. You know, that's just a part of, you know, how you grow up. I'm not going to act like, you know, you know how it is. I know people from the turf. So it's like. When people see something special in you, they usually try to keep you from doing anything crazy. You know what I mean? So even if you out there acting a fool, you know, you got big homies from both sides. Like, listen, dog, this ain't what you need to be doing. Go home. You know what I mean? So I got to give a shout out to some of those dudes. So it's good looking. Even you, like, you know, you a DJ, but you done been in every corner. So you know how it go. You see what I'm saying?
But you also had those too. I mean, I've seen it. I've been right there where, you know, some niggas is encouraging it. Like, nah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but you know,
lost a lot of talent here, bro, to the street life. For sure.
You're right, and that's because
it's so glorified when you hear these rappers and stuff sometimes, which I'm not knocking because you can rap all your, do what you do. But sometimes, you know, when you're rapping about it and you're hearing it, sometimes people just, they're glorifying the wrong thing. Right. People think going to school and getting a degree is stupid. Right. You know what I mean? Like, I went to USC. I went to one of the most, you know, prolific colleges in the nation. And I never knew what that meant till now. You know what I mean? Right. So when I go back now and, you know, just see the impact that I had on, you know, numerous fans, it just, it, you know, it does something to you. It definitely does something to you, man.
So let's talk about that. Park Hill Pirates.
Yes, sir. Yeah, Denver South, too. Definitely Denver South.
Denver South, for sure, too.
Yeah.
To USC, man. Tell us about that recruiting process, man, and tell us what it was like during the recruiting process for USC.
You know, recruiting process for me was pretty crazy. Yeah. I had got to see a little bit with, like I said, because my cousins was older, so I got to see a little bit with them. But, you know, man, just going through that whole stuff, it's like it's just like you see on the movies. Like when colleges fly you in and they sit you down, you know, it's crazy because I was talking to Dino about this. You know, everybody's going to be the man when they fly you in to give you the scholarship. Right. They're going to wine and dine you, get the biggest lobster tail you can ever imagine, go to room service, order whatever you can imagine. You know, that's what they're doing. So in their mind, you like, oh, my God, this is how it is.
Right.
You know, when you get there, reality sets in. So either you fight to get to it or you know, you remain, you know, on a lower level. So it's about that hunger in you.
Now, I'm sure there was other options. What other options was it besides USC, and what made you actually choose USC over the others?
Well, shout out to my brothers, Bo and Bo Skate from Denver, Colorado.
Okay.
Vince Young, my dog. I went down to Texas. You know, Texas was definitely in the running. I had Oregon. Pitt, you know, it's crazy because Darcy, like I told y'all about my cousin Darcy, he keeps coming in effect because that was my guy. I always wanted to be like him growing up. So.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, he went to Pitt. So, you know, Brennan Carroll's son, or Pete Carroll's son, actually went to Pitt. So I had went out there, and you know how stuff works out. You know, Brennan ends up graduating, and then he goes to be a GA at USC. But I went out there, and I thought Pitt was cool. You know, there's other schools that I had went to. I can't really think about them right now. I think, what was it like? I mean, all the schools, I had offers from everyone, but I only took – I really was looking at Texas, K-State, because Allen was there, and you know, USC, and you know, a lot of people think this is a funny joke, but you know, Ricky, my dog Ricky, was supposed to go to USC. Yeah. People be thinking when I tell him I went to USC for Ricky, they be thinking it's a joke. But I'd be like, when I went out there, man, Mike Williams and the whole crew, it was just so special. And to be in Southern California, man, I never knew I was gonna go out there and win. You know, playing three straight natties. You know, I never thought, you know, what was going to happen from there. But when I got there, the dream they sold me was better than everybody else's, period.
So, did you realize just how popping it was going to be before you even got there? Like, did you think about it?
When you're young, you see stuff. Like, I ain't going to act like I didn't. When I went out there, we went to the House of Blues, you know, got – I seen Shaq, you know, it was the Lakers back then. This is right before that, you know, Chauncey and them had, you know, broke up them. Yeah. So, you know, Lakers was pretty big. So it was cool. Like, it was a vibe. And I'm like, this is L.A. So, you know, I'm in Hollywood. It was amazing to me. I never knew that I was really going to be in L.A. like that till I got there. And, you know, 6 months later, you know, you went in and stuff. And then it's a whole different world.
Right. How's your relationship now with, you know, Pete Carroll and Reggie Bush and all those guys? You start with
I talk to, you know, at least there's like 45 guys, former guys in a group text. We text every day. And you know, that's Reggie, Matt, you know, Dominique Bird, Frosty Rucker. There's so many people that went to USC that we definitely talk to. But other than that, like, man, like Pete Carroll, I ain't talked to Pete or seen Pete in a long time, but we got on a Zoom call not too long ago, and we talked, and, you know, it felt good. You know, we always don't see eye to eye, and you know how that is. You can – when you play for certain coaches, you ain't going to do that. But the time we had there, the fact that we won, and, you know, we was able to win national championship, I can never knock Pete, so he's my guy forever.
Yeah. Big relationship with Snoop Dogg, and Snoop, a big Lendale fan. Is that, how's that relationship? That relationship still intact?
Oh yeah, that's solid. You know, it's so crazy because you know with the pandemic things just mess up stuff. But he was coming to Tetra for you know my dog Dwayne. He was gonna do a little thing there for me, so that was 420. But you know how that ended up working out. But yeah, me and dog are we locked in. You know that was just something. I don't know what he's seen in me from a long time ago, but he had brought me in, and he's always been like a you know older brother that's always told me. You know, right from wrong. He's always trying to give me game. And that's what I can respect about him more than anything. He gives me real game. He don't want you to be like anybody else, man. Right. So like when you look at our relationship, like every time you come in town or whatever, there's a you know, if I'm there and he know I'm there, you know, I got the link. All I gotta do is, you know, reach out to one person and usually I you know, I'm there. So it's not even an issue. That's my dog.
How important is it to tell the people how important it is to really keep and sustain relationships, man, in the industry, man, in football. I mean, just period in life.
Well, that's the, you know, people told us a long time ago when we was growing up, like, you know, you don't ruin something now, you know, for because you never know what you're going to need down the road. And sometimes, you know, when you're young, you don't think you need nobody. So you'll cuss out somebody or not go to a meeting or, you know, stand somebody up when they want to, you know, hang out or do something like that, not realizing that, listen, these people grind just like you. They may not be popular like you, but you might inspire them in a way to where you standing them up on, you know, not hanging out with them probably made them so hungry to where they blew past you. You know what I mean? And now they looking at you and you like, man, we should link up, and they giving you the cold shoulder. You know what I mean? So, man, relationships are everything. It's not about what you know in life. It's about who you know. I don't care who tell you go to school and learn all the. Yeah, that's great for paperwork. But, man, listen, it's about who you know. And it'll get it right every time.
One thing I always learned. There's some game I always learned. I always kept in my head. What you know is going to get you in. I mean, who you know is going to get you in. What you know is going to keep you in.
For sure. Oh, no, for sure. Now, you got to be knowledgeable about everything. You can't be no dummy, you know, thinking you're going to just finesse somebody. You got to, you know, stay in them books. I don't care if it's school. The NFL is probably the hardest thing in the world to make because it's 1%. You know, there's 100 guys on rosters today with 32 teams, man. That's 3,200 people out there trying to make a team. You know what I mean? So one thing that separates people usually in that is how smart you are. You know what I mean? Like, can we rely on you? Like, what are your coaching? Like, are you coachable? And, you know, sometimes people take that the wrong way. Sometimes coaches get on you or, you know, they tell you certain things. You looking at them like, you know, coach ain't fucking with me. He don't know nothing. He just trying to, you know, stop me from shining. When really the man trying to set you up for ultimate, you know, not for no failure, but for ultimate success.
Definitely. Walk us through the NFL draft day.
Well, NFL draft day, I was, you know, my mom was there, KO, my brother, Uncle Herm. Well, the whole family was there, man. We was at Skyland. Yeah. That's what I call it. I know some of y'all might know it as Hiawatha, but I was at Skyland because that's where I played all my ball growing up. And, man, it was just so surreal. Obviously, you know, I know, like, going into it, I had some question marks. So I thought I was going first round, but I kind of knew that, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if I failed. But, you know, once you get your name called and you – and then people call you on the phone and they like, listen, this is where you're going. The feeling that goes through your body is probably the most electric feeling you can have. I mean, I don't have any kids now. So, you know, people tell me it's like having kids, but I know it's like that because this is something you worked for your whole life and now it paid off. You know what I mean? It's the greatest feeling in the world.
Besides that, I'm sure that's one of the most memorable moments, but what's one of your most memorable moments in the NFL that you can remember? Whether it was a game, whether it was in a locker room, after the game, most memorable moment that you could think of?
I mean, I got so many. Obviously, scoring an 80-yard touchdown in the NFL ain't easy. So that's definitely one of them up there. But I have stories like, you know, hanging out the night before and almost
give us
being
one. Give us one. Give
you
us
know,
one.
Like almost being late, you know, like, man, just going to, you're hanging out with Lil Wayne and, you know, just hanging out all night. And, you know, we got practice the next day, but this is like Wednesday night and, you know, the city on fire. So you just hanging out and, you know, we get home, we go to sleep. And, you know, my dog CJ called me like, where you at? And I'm like, what you mean where I'm at? And I look at the clock and I'm like, oh, man, it's about to be one. You know, because I know I'm running late, man. So ultimately I'm late and I get there. And, you know, coach asked me, man, like he say, ask everybody why they was late. Bro, this man crazy, CJ over here, y'all. This dude crazy. Hey, the man, hey, coach asked me what happened. He said, why you was late? I said, coach, I had to use the bathroom.
Yeah.
Bro, that man looked at me like, shut the F up, bro. Don't worry about it. Bro, when I tell you, every time we got the ball in practice, he made a sprint 80 yards, bro. And it was just me. It was me and CJ. We had to, you know, every carry. So he'll go 80. I had to come back. And, bro, it was ridiculous. But we were so young and tipsy from the night before, you know, we in there like, you know, this, are you not entertained? This is, what more do you want from me? You know, the older heads in there, they loving it because, you know, they couldn't break us. So that was, you know, one of the stories that I definitely remember, man.
Yes. Big shout to CJ too, man. You know, I know a lot of people, you know, full with CJ, man, and y'all was killing out there, man, for sure.
Yeah, you know, and that's another thing about, like, relationships. You know, you never know where it's going to lead you in life or how it is, but, you know, that's dog for life. He's always been, you know, one of them dudes. There was times in my life, you know, it ain't always been good. You know, I've been dark places. I can't lie. So he was one of them dudes that helped me get out of that. And, you know, my respect, you know, I got nothing but the utmost respect for him.
For sure.
Dax Fifth, what up?
What do you feel was one of your biggest mistakes that hindered your career?
Well, my number one mistake was not taking it seriously, man. Like, I just really feel like I didn't feel like I had to work out that much.
Yeah.
You know, I can literally tell y'all on this thing right now that I ran for 1,000 yards and I wasn't working out in the off season. Like, that just wasn't something I was doing. Drinking Patron. You know, probably smoking, doing whatever the hell I wasn't supposed to be doing. But, you know, that's my number one downfall. I didn't take it seriously, and I didn't respect the time I had in there. You know what I mean? I just, you know, doing what I did without, you know, like, having to work, I thought that shit was easy. You know what I mean? I'm like, man, this shit gonna be cakewalk. You know, little do I know, like, these people all are friends. That's what I'm trying to tell people about. It's not about what you know, it's who you know. Because they going to talk, and they going to be like, how you feel about him? Some of them fools going to be like, man, listen. I wouldn't let my daughter date him with his best friends. You know what I mean? Whatever. So, you know, that's about relationships and not ruining that. And I, you know, if I can go back, if there's anything you could probably change in life, it would probably be, you know, like, working out. You know, being with my Uncle Herman all the time and, you know, just getting that little 2-hour workout a day. Yeah.
What's life like after football for Lendale right now?
Life is great, man. I'm alive and living. I can't complain about nothing. You know, I got friends and I got people that I play with that's no longer with us. You know what I'm saying? So, like, being 35 now, being a black male in today's society, you know, I'm proud to be alive. You know what I mean? With that being said, I got so much more living to do. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this, sometimes you, like I said, you got bumps in the road and all. The fact that I can do this show with you and, you know, the fact that you got respect for me. You know, I ain't played football in 10 years, you know what I mean? But I know you got love for me like that. That just shows me that, you know, ain't nothing over. You know what I mean? It's just about what you put your grind into, you know, and that's what I got to tell people. Like, don't worry about what another man doing. You can't watch another man's pockets. Put your grind in yourself and everything going to be fine. I'm telling you that.
I mean, you know, it's love with us for sure, man. But I see you really have a story, bro. Like, you have a story that could help so many kids.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, I've been, you know, there's a lot of stuff that's been weighing on me heavy. You know, I feel like, you know, coaching been calling me. He's calling me somehow, some way.
Yeah.
Life coaching is something, you know, I don't know. I'm not going to act like, you know, I can probably just give. I don't know if I'm ready or mature enough. That's the word. I'm not mature enough to probably go out there and get them kids and tell them kids every day what they got to do right and wrong. You know what I mean?
Right.
But I definitely can get them game on experience and what I did wrong to help them not do that. You know what I mean? And like you said, if it helps one, that's, I did something.
But there's a lane for that.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about it. Like, you know, we talk all the time.
Let's rap. I'm down. You know, I ain't never running.
There's a lane for that, bro. For real.
Squizzy, what up?
We're gonna figure that out. Chucks or G-Nikes?
Chucks or G-Nikes? I'm a Chuck guy, man. I can't cap. I'm a Chuck.
Okay. Wellness Street Cafe or Pete's Kitchen?
I'm Welton Street, man. You don't know about Welton Street. Hey, he done been to Welton Street.
Huh?
You know, them wings, remember we went to Denver? The wings when we went to Denver? Or the port, in the pork chop.
Oh, yeah. Elitch is a lakeside.
Listen, I'm a lakeside nigga, man. Cause
you on like, that chipmunk?
Man, I'm on the chipmunk. And all I got is a 20 ski. So listen,
you know, I'll stay there.
Man, listen, you know, you go to Elitch's with a 20, you dead. You ain't even getting in there, bro.
You ain't getting in, bro, on everything. All right, so look, true story. You know, I had Big Bro Chauncey Billups on, right?
Yeah.
So we asked him. He couldn't do it. We asked him, name Can you name all the Park Hill streets in order from Colorado Boulevard to Quebec? Can you do it?
Nah. Too many hits to the head. Listen. You got to understand. There's certain. I know where. I just know them by the back of my hand. Just driving up them for so long, you know them. I just, you know, I'm going to get some of them wrong. I can't even cap. I know I will.
I'm going to help
you. I just know them.
All right, let's get to Monaco might be too long. Let's get to Holly.
Oh, my gosh.
Can we get to Holly?
Bro, I'm a nail. Like, yeah, I can't even. When you say Holly, all I see is Thrill.
Thrill place.
You see what I'm saying? Like, I see the side street. Like,
yeah, that's the side you ain't even gonna. That's the red bricks. We ain't even gonna name it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Don't leave Trill. We ain't even
gonna. Yeah, I'm a nail, man.
Tell us some of the influential people, you know, from your area that you looked up to growing up.
You said people from the local area?
Yeah, some influential people. For you growing up in the area?
Well, you know, I mean, for sure, Chauncey was probably the number one. You know, my cousins, I said it before, Herm, yeah. Darcy, my big brother, Kenny. There was people like Keneal Dickerson, you know what I mean, seen from afar.
Yeah.
Stan King, yeah. Rodney Billups. I mean, there's people that I've always had, you know, Alan Webb. Quentin Tweed, like these are people I always respected because I've seen they grind, you know, growing up, and I've seen where they are as, you know, as men now. You know, they taking care of their families, doing what they got to do. So, like, you know, Shoddy,
yeah, Shoddy for sure.
Yeah, Courtney Hysaw, like, bro, you know, like, there's so many. I can't even act like that, man. There's so many people. Ross, Corey Ross, Roman Hollowell. You know, these is. You feel me? These are fools that I wish I could have been. I could have been like, had that little wiggle like Roman. I probably would have been super crazy.
Roman was stupid.
My dog, Sax Fifth, listen, you know, I ain't going to lie. Sax Fifth been on his, you know, if we all know from Park Hill, this little nigga been outside, you know, Fairfax grinding since he was a jit. So I ain't even going to act like that. And I haven't seen him come from, you know, little man on the corner to, you know, big dog. So I ain't got nothing but respect for my dog, Sax Fifth, too.
Yeah. Shout out to Sax for sure. He was just on. We just had him on the show on Sunday. Me and Squizzy on the clown. He killed us with the shoot game. But
yeah, he be. I ain't even home. I'll jump down on him. He know what's up.
Yeah,
that man crazy.
All right, so give me if you can give me your top five running backs from the city that never made it to the league.
Quincy Waller. Quincy Waller, number one.
Okay.
Sherrod Maxey.
Okay.
Slash.
Slash.
Lil Slash was sick.
Okay.
Well, Marcus Houston was decent. No, I can't put Marcus Houston in that. Because, buddy, let me see. My dog, man, I don't know. Leonard Jones was sick.
Okay.
Leonard Jones was sick, man. And then my brother Kenny. Because Kenny played everything. He just didn't want to do it. Like, you meet niggas like that every day. Kenny played every position on the field. Yeah. I remember there was a game I fumbled three times versus Hinkley, man. Like, I fumbled three times. I thought I was just the man. My uncle pulled me so fast, and Kenny had two runs for, like, 80 yards and two TDs. My uncle looked at me. I'm like, listen, I'm ready again. I'm ready. I'm ready.
For sure. Give me your
Man, my dog Mike Houston, too, man. Damn, Mike Houston.
I'm sure. I know it's a lot, but it's always – look, now it's going to be in your head. You're going to be thinking about it.
Yeah, like, for real, dog. Damn.
It's a lot. We got some dogs, man.
For real. Because there were some boys out there like Bear Creek and like Columbine that bug a running back. There was a quarterback, Tanner Rogers, that was an animal back then.
Yeah. Give me your all-time, if you could think about it, your all-time starting 11 Pro Bowl. If you could build a team, if you built a team right now, just anybody from any era, any decade, your starting 11 for the Pro Bowl.
On offense right now?
Offense.
Tom Brady at quarterback. Ain't okay. No ifs, ands. We're going to have Randy Moss out there.
Okay.
I'm going to have – dang, boy, that's rough because there's Antonio Gates and Tony Gonzalez.
Yeah.
So I might go one of them. I might go both of them and not have a fullback.
Okay.
Other than myself at tailback, I ain't on that. But I like 2K because I seen what he did up in personal. Like, I ain't going to lie. I'll put Young on that team.
Yeah.
The linemen, you got Big Walter Stanley. I got Kevin Mawai at center because that was one of my centers. Dang, bro. I don't even – bro, there's so many people right now telling you put me on the spot. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Wow, bro. Like, guards? Dang.
You might not – you ain't got that many guards.
Oh, y'all don't even know the guards, but yeah, my other receiver, who would be my other receiver? Because I'm going Randy Moss. There's only right I go Randy Moss. Yeah. But see, I got to go with somebody from my era because I love it. I like Randy Moss, and I like Megatron on the other side.
Megatron, okay.
That's going to be a crazy lineup, you know what I mean? Yeah. You can't double both of them.
Yeah. Okay, I like that. What makes a great running back?
A great running back usually has patience. Patience are a virtue in running the ball, you know, because you got to let things set up. You got to be smart. You got to be reactive. You know what I mean? You can't be – don't think. You got to react. You got to be instinctual. You know what I mean? I think the best, honestly, the best thing is for playing running back, other than being smart and knowing what you're up against, you know, like why the three technique is on your side sometimes, or why the safety's coming down, why the corner's, you know, creeping off the edge. Like, other than being smart, I would just say, like, not thinking about the game. Like, once you take out the thought process of the game and you know what to do, it makes the game a million times easier. That's just realistic.
Who was one of your toughest defenders that you can recall? You used to hate playing against when y'all played.
Man, what's Buddy's name from Cleveland, bro? Oh, DeQuell Jackson. DeQuell Jackson. Yeah, he played for Cleveland back then. The man used to thud so hard, bro. And they was sorry, y'all, that he didn't care about none of that. He still coming to hit you every play. He didn't care. Nigga, DeQuell Jackson for real. I'll never forget that, boy.
Yeah. What music? What music is Lendale listening to?
I feel like I be from Atlanta. I can't lie, man, because I'm like a little baby Gunna. You know, I listen to Trev Rich, AP, yeah. Sax Fifth. I definitely listen to Hometown, but when I don't, I'm definitely like Atlanta based. I can't even cap.
Definitely.
I've been riding that new Pop Smoke too. Pop been pop hard.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, Jay-Z, Wayne, and Drake is like, them is norm. Yeah.
You just named some heavy hitters in the town, man. Tell us, in your eyes, man, about the Denver music scene from your view.
I never worked. It's tough. I see them boys out there working. You know, I can't act like I don't see them. So,
yeah. You
know, bro, just being from Colorado, it's just already like a black ball. Because for some reason, they don't believe in black people in Colorado for some reason. It's the weirdest shit ever. But I'll line Trev, Rich, AP, and Sax, the Filthy out there, Flawless. Listen, I'll line these dogs up against any of them niggas. I love it. Like, I love this. Especially, listen, when we talking about bars and some of this stuff, like, you know, some of this stuff go over people's heads. Some of that stuff Sax Fifth talk, like, people don't even understand it because they ain't never visit the places he been and stuff like that. They don't understand that.
When you think of Denver, not necessarily music, but just when you think of Denver, think of what?
Me, I think of that tree, man. I love my city. Like, I feel like everybody know us for weed. You know what I mean? I mean, it's a good, bad, or indifferent, but I done seen, you know, doctors, lawyers, you know, nurse, whatever. I done seen them travel to Denver to get their little experience in. So when I think about Denver, I think about, you know, being mile high, niggas being high.
Definitely. You been following the presidential election and
Yeah, man. I ain't even going to play with that one, though. I ain't even going.
No.
Yeah, nah, Tony, listen, them people crazy. Them folks, they're... Because, listen, if I think Orange Hair is any... Like, he a clown. I'm not going to act like dog ain't no clown. We'll be a fool not to see that. But I just... You know what I mean? Sometimes, you know, one of my coaches told me sometimes you got to go with the evil you already know.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like... I don't know. Like, you know, when you do your research on some of these people, some of this stuff ain't coming back all clean. You know what I mean? So you just, I guess, you know, I tell people just go out and vote. Make sure you vote. You know, whoever you vote for, you vote. Just do it. So it ain't no mix up when, you know, when the election comes out and y'all mad.
Well, tell me this. You voting for Kanye?
I don't know, man. Listen, me and Kanye kind of the same. We ain't got our, like, we, you know what I mean? So ain't no telling how he feels every day. I can't vote for a nigga that might, he don't know what he gonna do from day to day.
Right.
You know, if I knew his intention was like, you know, if we knew he had a solid intention, if we were talking about like Jay-Z or somebody, it'd be different. You know what I mean?
Right.
But nah, I don't think I'm voting for dog.
If you could talk to 20-year-old Lendale, what you gonna tell him right now?
Never stop believing. You know, when we kids, you believe that you could be anything, right? And then you get to a certain age, you play its course, and then you forget that you know, that when you was a kid, everything you thought was gonna happen, like you was dreaming about that. You brought that into fruition. So like, when you stop believing in stuff, sometimes, you know what I mean. You don't have that want to, that grind, you know, that to go get it. So I would tell people, you don't ever stop believing. You still, like, I don't care at 20, anything that you think you can do, it's still possible. It ain't never over till it's over.
So that's probably kind of the same answer you're going to answer this, but I was going to say, what advice do you have for an up-and-coming baller right now, today?
An up-and-coming baller right now, I would tell them, listen, don't let nobody work harder than you. Be the guy people talk about. Like, man, this nigga always working out, man. So what? Like, you want to get to a place that these niggas is talking about. So what? Why not separate yourself? You know what I mean?
Right.
I would be, you know how when we see, you know, on Instagram, you turn on Odell's page and the nigga always catching one-hand balls and working out. He's right. Always perfecting his grind. I would tell you, perfect your grind and never stop. When you think it's perfected, turn it up more.
Off top. Yeah. Any young ballers, running backs, anybody from the city that people need to be looking out for coming up?
Yeah, you already know that, bro. Listen, I really, Dino, my guy.
Yeah.
I know Dino, you know, and I just talked to him, so I feel like this is going to be a big year for him. You know, I feel like, you know, I've seen what he did in high school, so I know the talent's there. You know, now it's just time to get on the – you got to get past the initial step, and they try to break you down there. I don't care who you are. When you first get to college, first 2 years, they'll feed you to the Gators till you come out of that and show them that you're hungry for whatever.
Right.
So, I mean, I'm looking out for Dino. That's who I – you know, that's my brother, so I'm looking out for him, really.
Yeah, that's the Keon Martinez, 21.
For real. 2-1 game.
For sure. Anybody else?
That you man, I ain't even, you know, I don't, I got love for Philip Lindsay. I want to see him ball out. I want to see little Eckler, Austin Eckler from the San Diego, because I heard he's from Colorado. Yeah. You know, if you're from Colorado, all I want to see you do is ball, because we don't get enough respect, and they don't put respect on our name. So if they out there, you know, all I want to do is see him ball, really.
Funny question, right?
No. Yeah.
It's 3 a.m., right?
Yeah.
You stranded. Would you rather be dead smack in the bellows, or would you rather be on the inside stranded?
I'm going my bellow, first quarter. Drop me off in my bellow, stranded. Ain't no, hey, y'all, hey, are we talking about gentrified east side, or are we talking about?
No, we talking about.
Oh, no, no, Sirski. I don't want to be at Welcome Street just out there hanging out for no reason. No, sir. Right, y'all tripping. Like, listen, I can go to the
To the bell, drop me off in the bell.
Yeah, drop me off on the 5-5. I would love it. At least I know family and all out there.
Yeah.
Listen, the East Side like South Central. Niggas think it's a game.
Yeah, man. Big shout to the East Side, man. When niggas don't play with the East Side, man. Especially not that late.
You can't, bro. Listen, you got to be out of town or playing with them folks like that, because it ain't like they soft. Like, you got to just be understanding where you at now.
On everything.
I got family from both sides. Like, that ain't a question, but I'm going to Montbello first.
I'm in Montbello too.
Yeah.
What's next for Lendale, man? What's next for ShowCase?
You know, I got some things in store. Obviously, you know, I do my little commentate, and then, you know, I do my radio gigs here and there. So,
yeah.
I got that down. I would probably say, like, the next thing for me would probably be, I don't know, I want to get in this CBD and make like a powerful CBD line for, you know, real athletes. Like, I don't want that stuff where they say it work. I want that stuff where you put it on, you can feel an absolute difference, you know. So I'm thinking about, you know, getting in some CBD stuff, chapsticks, But you know, man, sky's the limit. Depend on, you know, whatever I just put my foot on. You know, man, I got some things out there.
I used to always, I don't know if you remember what the idea I always would tell you.
What you talking about? Remember? What you talking about?
We need Lendale. We might as well do a Lendale steakhouse, man.
I know, bro, but right now, we this go crazy right now because of the pandemic.
Man, we gonna work on that for after me. Matter of fact, Sax, me, you and Sax.
You know what we need to do? See, listen, though. We need to do some shit. You know how the bitches be in Atlanta, bro. We need to talk. That's what we needed, like.
Yeah.
You know, like some sexy, classy stuff.
That's what I'm telling you.
For real,
me,
I'm with
Sax,
that.
Let's get on the horn. Let's put this paper up. Put this paper together. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Last two questions, man. Finish the sentence. Lendale White is.
I got two different answers. Lendale White is, you know, I'm grateful for sure. Yeah. I'm always grateful, man, because, you know, I've experienced some stuff in my life where, you know, it probably wasn't supposed to be here. So I'm grateful to be alive. So that's number one for sure. I'm grateful.
Definitely. DJ Ktone is.
The GOAT. DJ Ktone, the GOAT. That ain't even a question. That ain't even a question. I used to go to the club just to sit in your booth. You know that. Like, I ain't going nowhere but you. I'm texting you the whole night. Where you at? I'm pulling up on you.
Oh, there it is, man. Hold on. I appreciate it. Hold on. I want to play something from the town, man. I'm going to do that. What you want to hear, man? What you want to let's play something for the town, for the people, man.
Bro, you the turf DJ, so I'm going to you.
I came in with some Iman. I came in with some AP and Iman. Hold on, man. Let's do something classic. I mean, let's do something dope right now. Matter of fact, you know what we're going to do? We're going to do one of the hardest records in the city, man. That shout out to 10 of 10 Birds. Shout out to 100 Rack 6. We're going to do that dope boy.
Oh, yeah, my dog. That's my dog. Let's do that real
quick. If you got some questions for Lendale, man, put it in the chat. We're just going to rock out real quick. Hold on, Lendale.
Let's do it.
We're just going to jam out real quick. We're going to do some Denver music. We're going to do some Denver hustle music. Lendale, ShowCase White, if you got the question for him, holla at him. Holla at him.
I'm a motherfucking dope boy. I'm a dope boy. Big stumping in my dope boys. I'm a dope boy. Hustling for that dope boy. I'm a dope boy. I'm a
motherfucking
dope boy. I'm a dope boy.
I know you've been out the city, Lendale, but this is one of the hardest records coming out. One of the hardest records out.
Put me on.
Not just in Denver, but this is the hardest records in the city on everything.
Dope boy, I'm traveling like it's 1994. Junkies at the dope, best price, and I got the best dope. Best, I'ma get them Gucci's out of hoe. Going fully with the hoe, I got the best pipe, she got the best dope. I'm the sensor, what you know about the powder and the blender. Trapper of the year, I'm a motherfucking winner. Baby says she tryna see some money, I'm a sinner. Baby got a good trick, baby he a good tipper. Ay, I be in the kitchen tryna whip.
Make sure y'all follow ShowCase White. With the Benz, you got some questions up there. You got some questions, Lendale. Down, they can hear you too. They can hear you. Get the road
running. My dream team to play for.
I'm a dope boy. I'm a dope boy.
Big probably like the Miami Dolphins.
Boys. I'm a dope boy.
Or the LA Rams.
For that dope boy. I'm a dope boy. I'm a motherfucking dope boy. I'm a dope boy. Dope boy.
Yes, Zach, you know, send that to me ASAP.
Dope boy. Dope boy. Motherfucking dope boy.
Dope boy. I'm the third DJ, and you know. Wax, you are not a slave. You actually might be.
What up, Wax? What up, Wax?
No, Wax.
Follow at. Make sure you follow me at DJ Ktone. Follow ShowCase White right now. Balled out.
I definitely plan on having kids. No, not the cowgirl. I mean the cowboy. No, sir. That's yeah. 10 and 100 racks.
That artist right there, that was 10 and 10 bars in 100 racks 6. It's called Dope Boy. Big shout to Lendale White. Big shout to PH Cuz. You see my shirt, Lendale? Hold on. You see my shirt? That's the greatest. That's Sade right there.
Oh, yeah, that's hard. But you always got something going on, though.
Hold on, Lindell. Hold on. With the matching socks. Hold up.
Well, you got a fit on right now. Come on, y'all don't even know who Ktone is.
Come on, man. And look, we're going to take care of you, too. We're going to get you. I got you some custom. from PH Customs. Shout out to PH Customs. They're going to make you something custom. And I feel like, you know, I've been feeling like lately, I like to give my people flowers while they're alive, bro. For real.
Yes, man. Sir. I appreciate that.
Definitely. And I got you a pair of these. I'm on everything.
On everything. Believe that. Good looking, boy. Hell yeah.
Any last words you want to tell the people before we get up out of here?
Man, nah, I appreciate you, Tony, like, for real, man. You know, shit, this stuff like this helps us a lot, you know. Sometimes you don't think, you know, you got fans or you got people that you might be able to reach. So I appreciate you giving this platform, real talk.
Bro, you never know who you're going to touch, man, I'm telling you. On everything I love, and it only take one.
Yes, sir, that's all it takes.
Definitely.
What up, Beast Mode?
Big shout out to Victory Clothing Boutique, man. You can get your socks at Victory Clothing.
Oh, yes. Here say she got my pillowcase, too. Yes, sir. I need that.
Big shout out to Sleepers Pretty Pillowcases.
Yes.
You got to get you the pillowcases, man. Keep the locks right, man.
You feel me? I see you over there, boy. I see you.
That man. You know, I told you I was coming long time
ago. I know. You told me that.
I'm here now.
Yeah, I ain't.
Hold on. This is the goat right here, though. Come on. Come here.
Yeah, I know. Hey, bro, don't bring dog over there. Yeah, I didn't see. Hey, don't.
Yeah,
He's cheating. Yeah, he cheating, bro. On that. Little kid hair grow different, man.
Man, on everything. But for sure, man, let me know when you come back to the city. It's all good.
Easy call. I appreciate it, Cunt. Love you, bro.
Love you, too, on everything.
Believe that.
One love. Make sure y'all follow Lendale at Showcase White on IG. Support everything. We're going to get the steakhouse going. Iman hit me. We're going to get the steakhouse going. Make sure y'all have to sleep with pretty pillowcases. Get your sleeping pretty pillowcase. Look. Have your hair all the way right. Big shout out to PH Customs for the shirt. That's my Sade shirt. That's the best singer ever to do it. My socks, my custom socks. You can get anything custom. Holla at them. And 20 and 20 next week, Monday, 20 and 20, August 24th, I got I Am Sue. Tuesday, special Tuesday edition. I got Houston's own Beat King. Monday, I Am Sue. Tuesday, Beat King. And go to my YouTube. Subscribe to the YouTube. DJ Ktone on the Turf, DJ on YouTube. You can watch all the 2020s. You can go back and watch them. Run me up. Appreciate you.